first in my new makeup series, and it feels like I haven't filmed a tutorial forever, but I haven't really been that inspired to do anything, so I'm glad that I thought of this new series, and it's going to be based off of the Hunger Games books. And if you guys don't know what the Hunger Games are, it's this book series, but well, series of books, and I have them, I've read them all and I'm obsessed, I love them all. And they've made the first one, this one, into a film, and I will leave the trailer below, because the trailer was actually in my playlist of love, and so because I love it. But if you guys haven't seen it, I will leave the link to the trailer below and maybe the Wikipedia page for the books, or some sort of synopsis, so that you guys kind of know what I'm banging on about. But in the book there are 13, depending, there are 13 districts, and well, technically anyway, and it's set in America, but it's not called America, it's called Panem, I think, and it's in like the future, where kind of war has ravaged America. So each of the districts, they don't have states anymore, each of the districts has a different thing that they produce. So for this first one that I've done, it's for District 1, and District 1 has, they produce luxury items for the capital, so that's why I've gone for like purples and gold. I'm really sorry about the lighting, but I was like failing at my intro for ages, so it's gone dark outside, but in the tutorial it's not that dark. But anyway, yes, all of the districts represent something different, so I will be hopefully doing all of the districts, and I think this is going to last up until the release of the movie, I think, because there's a lot of looks to do, so it's not going to be a look every week. It just depends, but I'll try and get them all up before the film comes out. If you have any questions, because I know maybe not all of you would like have read this book or know what I'm going on about, if you have any questions, leave it below and I will try and answer the best I can. And let me know what you guys think of this new series, and I'm going to jump into the tutorial.
I primed my eye with Too Faced Shadow Insurance, and I use this purple cream shadow from e.l.f. as a base. I'm taking MAC Swiss Chocolate and I'm just running it through my crease. This not only helps to create depth, but also helps when it comes to blending out any colours that I'll be using on my eye later on. This lilac, which is from the bottom set of colours from my 120 palette, I'm using that all over my lid, just stopping short of the corner of my eye. Taking my Crown Pro Blending Fluff Brush, I'm picking up this Inglot Purple, and it's a matte shade with really small gold glitters in it. I'm just putting it in the corner of my eye and then taking it slightly through my crease. The problem with the lilac colour that I used before is that it's pretty rubbish and it doesn't build back up quite easily with a brush, so I'm just using my fingers to reapply and build up the colour again. Using my Crown Stiff Tapered Crease Brush, I'm taking a matte black shadow and I'm just concentrating that in the corner of my eye, just at my lash line, and I'm also taking it really slightly into my crease. Now you're going to prime the inner corner of your lower lash line, and I'm taking this pencil brush and this gold shade from my Inglot palette and I'm just placing that over where I put the primer. You want to take a black pencil and line the rest of the lower lash line, and I'm using a liquid liner here to line the top lash line. I'm using my MSF Natural in Dark to blend out any harsh lines. Now I'm putting mascara on my top and bottom lashes. For your bottom lashes, you want to make sure to just put the mascara where you put the black pencil. For the false lashes, I just cut them in half and put the shortest section on the end of my eye, and those are the eyes done. I'm taking this purple blush and it's Sin by Illamasqua, and what I'm doing is I'm really blending it out after I've placed it on my cheek, because the blush is very pigmented. For my lipstick, I'm using Nougat by Gosh, which is a pinky nude shade. On top of the lipstick, you want to place a nude or neutral lip gloss. and your look is complete.